Hi, my name's Jenny and I'm a mind body coach. And welcome back to my 30-day challenge. Today is a yoga day. We're going to do like a nice, slow, gentle flow, just to really stretch out and just get the body moving. I'll try and sort of go slowly and just stretch everything out that we've been using. So just listen to your body, do what you can, and we'll just get started. So starting off, going to sit back. So knees together, tuck your toes under, and then sitting on your heels. So we're stretching out the inner arches of the feet. You're going to bring your arms up. Do a cactus arch. So inhale, open your chest up. Exhale, curling back, scooping back, bring the elbows together. Inhale, open up your chest. And exhale, curl forward. So you're trying to sit back, weight on your heels to get more of that stretch. Inhale, open. Exhale, curl back. Just do a couple more. Last one. And then you can just release your toes. Tap them out a little bit. Bring your knees the width of the mat and come into extended child pose. Forehead to the mat and just stretch back. Sitting your bum onto your heels. Press down into the mat and just hold it here. So nice deep breath in through the nose, out through your nose. Nice full deep inhales and full exhalation. Coming onto hands and knees. So you want your knees underneath your hips, hands underneath shoulders. Come into cat-cow. Inhale, arching your back, looking up to the ceiling. And then exhale, pressing the floor away, curling through the spine. Inhale, arching up, looking to the ceiling. And exhale, pressing the floor away. So you're going to start switching on your ujjayi breath. So that's your ocean breath, creating heat within the body. If you think about restricting the back of the throat, so you're kind of making a nice ocean sound. So it's an audible breath. We're also going to start switching on the bandha. So mother bandha, think pelvic floor. So let's just try to stop yourself going to the toilet. But only a gentle engagement. And then uddiyana bandha is like the transversal, so those lower abdominals. Sucking those in. Last one. And then coming to neutral. So you're going to tuck your toes under, lift your hips up, and come into downward facing dog. You can have your knees bent here, pressing your chest towards your thighs. You just start walking out of the dog, so press it down through one heel. Inhale to change, exhale to the other side. And just go side to side, nice and slowly. Pressing down through the whole hand, spreading your fingers wide, and broadening across your shoulders. And then we'll just hold downward facing. So you're lifting your sit bones towards the ceiling, belly up to spine, so again, still engaging through your bandhas. Looking to your knees. Nice, strong ujjayi breath still. And then just slowly start walking your feet towards your hands. Step by step. If you've got tight hamstrings, you can have your legs bent here. I've got a hamstring injury, so I always bend my knees in forward rolls. So the choice is yours. So if you come into brad dog, holding onto opposite elbows, just shaking your body side to side, nice and gently. Keeping your shoulders away from your ears. And then back to center. On the next inhale, slowly rolling up, scooping up vertebrae by vertebrae. All the way up, head comes up last. Just rolling your shoulders back a couple of times. Really doing a little lateral flexion. So inhale, reaching your arms up. Holding your left wrist with the right hand. Reaching up, and then taking a bend to the side without collapsing into the underside of your waist. Inhale to center. Exhale, changing sides. So you're lengthening to the side of your body. Shoulders away from your ears. Inhale to center. Exhale over. And then one more. Coming back to center. Bringing our hands down.
Then hands to heart centre, bringing your feet together. So we're looking to Surya Namaskara A, so Sun Salutation A. We're going to work with our breath and go slowly, really working, opening up through our legs. Bit of breath. Inhale, reaching the Cabrera, mini back, and squeeze your glutes to protect your lower back. Exhale, folding over your legs. Inhale, step the right leg back. Drop the back knee, looking up, so stretching through the front of the hip. Exhale, downward facing. Hold your breath, come to a plank, drop your knees, lower all the way down, elbows in. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale, tucking your toes under, sit back, lifting up, downward facing. Inhale, step the right foot between the hands, drop the back knee, looking up. Can you use your hand to help bring your leg forward? Exhale, folding over your legs. Inhale, reaching all the way up, mini back bend. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, folding in. Inhale, left leg back, drop your back knee, looking up. Exhale to downward facing. Come to a plank, drop to your knees, holding your breath level all the way down. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale, tuck your toes under, sit back, downward facing. Inhale, left foot between your hands, drop your back knee, looking up. Exhale, folding in. Inhale, reaching all the way up, mini back bend. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, folding in. Inhale, right leg back, drop your back knee, looking up. Exhale to downward facing. Hold your breath, come to a plank, drop to the knees, lower all the way down. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale to downward facing. Inhale, right foot between your hands, drop your back knee, looking up. Exhale, folding in. Inhale, reaching all the way up, mini back bend. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, folding in. Inhale, left leg back. Drop your back knee, looking up. Exhale to downward facing. Hold your breath, come to a plank, drop your knees lower all the way down. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale to downward facing. Inhale, left leg forward, drop your back knee, looking up. Exhale, folding in. Inhale, reaching all the way up, mini back bend. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, reaching up, last time on the right. Exhale, folding in. Inhale, right leg back, drop your back knee, looking up. Exhale to downward facing. Hold the breath, come to a plank, drop to knees level all the way down. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale to downward facing. Inhale, right leg forward, drop your back knee, looking up. Exhale, folding in. Inhale, reaching all the way up, mini back bend. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, folding in. Inhale, left leg back, drop your back knee, looking up. Exhale, downward facing. Hold your breath, come to a plank, drop your knees lower all the way down. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale, downward facing. Inhale, left foot forward, drop the back knee, looking up. Exhale, folding in. Inhale, reaching all the way up, mini back bend. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, reaching up, mini back bend. Exhale, folding in. Inhale, set your right foot back, drop the back knee. This time, untucking the toes, lifting up. Scooping the tailbone under, and then sort of engaging your lower abdominals with that body under, and then sink down. So we're not going into the lower back. And just hold it here. Each exhale, just trying to sink down a little bit lower, get stretched through the front of your hip. Couple more breaths. And bringing your right hand to the inside of your left foot. Reach back, find your foot if you can. So you can either stay here or come down onto your elbow. So get a nice stretch through your glute. Looking over your left shoulder, pulling the foot in. It's a little bit of a twist. Each exhale, just try to sink down into it. Put your front knee above the ankle.
Each exhale, just trying to let go of tension.
And straightening your back leg. Coming up, placing the hand either side of your foot, tuck your back toes under, and step back to downward facing. Inhale, come forward to a plank. Now, option to drop to your knees or come down through Chaturanga, bringing your chest forward, only coming to 90 degrees. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, to downward facing. Inhale, your right foot between your hands, drop the back knee. Untuck the toes, and then again, lifting up, scooping out your sit bones, scooping out your tailbone, and then sinking down, getting a stretch through the front of your hip. Using that Uddiyana Bandha to protect your lower back. Each exhale, just trying to sink down a little bit deeper. Again, a stretch in the front of your hip. Couple more breaths, just trying to let go. And then placing the hand on the inside of the foot. Again, go for your back foot, stretch through your quad. Staying on the hand, or again, dropping to your elbow. Pulling the foot in. Each exhale, just trying to let go a little bit more. Looking over your right shoulder. And release the foot. Placing the hands either side of your front foot. Tuck the back toes in again, step back to a plank. Low down, dropping on your knees, also activating through the legs, coming down to 90. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale to downward facing. Inhale, lift your right leg. Press it down through your left heel, but don't worry if it's not down. Even between both hands, pressing your chest towards your thighs. Reach through your right toe. So it's got these tense stretch through your left hamstring. Again, look into the knee or look into your toes. Hold it for one more breath. And then stepping your right foot between your hands. You're going to root down through the knife edge of your back foot. And then inhale, coming all the way up. Warrior two. You want your front knee stacked above the ankle. Grounding down to the knife edge of your back foot. Arms strong and active. Drawing your knee out to the side. Each exhale, trying to sink down a little bit deeper. Looking to the middle finger of your front fingers. Front hand. Active through both legs. Scooping your tailbone under. Hold it here for one more breath. Inhale, straighten your front leg. Then rebending it. You can either put your forearm onto your thigh. You can use a block on the outside of the foot, or bringing the hand down and then bring your arm overhead. Rotating your chest to the ceiling. Shoulder away from your ear and then turn your gaze to your palm of your top hand. Both legs are still active, so everything's really working here. Ujjayi breath, really strong. Then inhale, coming all the way up. We're going to turn our toes, turn your back foot in, left foot forward, and then exhale, sinking down to that warrior two. Fall over. To ground it down to the knife into the back foot, energy through your fingers, turn your gaze over that middle front finger. Just make sure you're drawing your knee out to the side without letting it collapse in. So you're not just hanging out in the process, everything's really active, your energy going everywhere. And then again, inhale, straighten your front leg, rebend it, and the same options as before. Try to rotate your chest towards the ceiling, gaze to your palm. So strong, full, slow breaths. And then inhale, coming all the way up. Going to turn both toes in, well, both feet in about 5 degrees. Inhale and then interlace your hands behind you. Inhale, opening your chest.
the kneecaps up and then bringing the weight forward. Again, exhale, trying to let go a little bit more. Full deep inhale and then exhale fully. And then bring the hand underneath you. Right hand grounds down. Keep your hips where you are, just open up. Again, twisting and looking up to your thumb. Weight even across both feet. And then replacing your left hand. Bringing the right hand up. Nice rotation through your upper back as you look towards the thumb. And then walking your hands back, tucking your back toe under and then lift up to three leg dogs. You can shake your leg out, releasing the knee and then replacing the foot. We'll do the same on the left. Inhale, lifting your left leg and then step it forward, coming to pigeon on your left. Bringing your chin forward again, flexing your left foot to protect the knee. Just check your legs straight along the mat and again, you can stay here. Or slowly coming down to mat down. Each exhale just letting go, releasing into the stretch. Gently coming back up. Again, placing the hands, tuck the back toes under, and coming into that three-leg dog, shaking your leg out. And then you're going to roll forward to a high plank. This time you're going to lower all the way down, so with control, nice and slowly, and then relax. So legs straight along the mat. We're going to start off with cobra. So lifting up, pulling your shoulders away from your ears, pressing down through your toes. Then you're going to, you can either stay here or hovering your hands. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale to hold. Inhale, lift. Exhale to hold. Three more breaths. Inhale, lift. Exhale, hold. Last one. And then come down. Put your arms alongside your body. Just head to one side. So on the next round, we're going to lift everything. If you've got any kind of lower back problems, you can just stay with the first version or just miss it up completely. So bringing your feet together. Again, interlace your hands behind you. This time you're going to inhale, lift arms and legs, and try to pull the fist away from you. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, hold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, hold. Three more breaths.
Inhale in and squeeze your glutes to lift the legs. Two more. Last one. And then come back, other cheek to the mat. Bring your legs up, just windscreen wipe it either side. And then pressing back to extend your child pose. Knees are width of the mat and just relax down here for a couple of breaths. And slowly rolling up. Just dropping your bum to the side, swinging your legs around. So we're going to come into a little twist. Left leg straight, bringing the right foot over the other side of your leg. So you can stay here if that's enough, or you can bend the left leg. We're going to be rooting down through the toe, and more importantly, rooting down through both sit bones, so you're protecting your lower back. Inhale, sweeping your arm behind, so right hand pressing close to your sacrum, so keeping you not torn. And lifting your left arm, hooking up and outside the knee, and just going for a little twist. Inhale, lengthen through your spine, exhale to twist. Each inhale, you're lengthening up, and then exhale to take that twist a little bit deeper. We want it to come from our upper back. Last one. And then a little deep rotation to the other side. And then releasing the legs. Other legs out, so right leg straight. Bring the foot on top, and then option to bend the knee. Just really make sure you're rooting down through both of your sit bones. Inhale, left arm behind, pressing you to sit up tall. Bring the right arm, use it for your twist. So inhale, lengthen, exhale to twist. You might find a little bit, you can go a little bit further on one side. Make sure you're rooting down through your sit bones. Make a little derotation. And then just come to cross-legged. Roll over your knees and then you can step or jump up to a plank. So again, either come straight to downward facing or you come through a chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale to downward facing. Look between your hands, in step or jump forward and come to sit. And then we're just going to come to a roll down, so slowly rolling down, vertebrae by vertebrae. And then just come into lying flat. It's going to take it into a happy baby. So you can either do half a happy baby, go to the outside of one foot, pulling the knee into the side, or you can go for both. Making sure your sacrum, so your lower back stays on the mat, and then just hold it here. If you like, you can rock side to side. Each exhale, drawing the knees down. So if you've done one side, release that. Release the leg and then go for the other one. Few more breaths. Just enjoy the stretch. Opening up your hips again. And then release, sliding your feet along the mat for Shavasana. So let your feet drop to the side, palms to the ceiling, and just come to the breath. Nice deep inhale, but just normal breath, releasing your ujjayi.